Well, you can tell from the accent that I'm not from around here, which is, I came about 23 years ago to the United States to do, well, I actually came to Vermont to work at the New England Culinary Institute. But before that, I wrote several books, which meant that I had to do a book tour. And I traveled around the United States and liked this area a lot. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here to start with is just to cream the butter and sugar. So we're making a little bit more than you would make at home, because we have to deal with much larger machines. So we don't make something where it's, you know, two or three cups. Normally we'd make 50 or 80 pounds of this in one go. So with this, obviously everything is already minced off. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here to start with is just to cream the butter and sugar. When you scrape it off, you wanna get it right down into the bottom of the bowl, because this is where the action is gonna happen. We're gonna add to that the sugar. You wanna start always on a slow speed to get everything incorporating before you then turn it up. So with this type of cookie, we wanna be able to cream it until it's light and fluffy. So light and fluffy is obviously taking that butter and adding more air so that you get a fraction of light, you get all those bubbles on the inside of it and it looks nice and light in color. So I'm gonna turn it down and we're gonna add the eggs. Now a lot of recipes will say that you wanna add your eggs one at a time, and that's because this is fat and this is fat, and to get those two different fats to emulsify, you wanna do it gradually. You don't just wanna do it all in one go. Back, we're gonna add two eggs. So you're mixing to incorporate. This will make about 24 cookies. To make this a little bit more interesting, I'm gonna put in some zest. So I've previously zested an orange and a lemon. We'll just give that a quick whiz. Okay, so this is flour and a little baking powder and just a tad of salt. Now this time it's very important, do not turn the mixture on if your machine is on fast, because otherwise you'll be wearing it. So keep it on a slow speed, and you're just incorporating these ingredients. And as soon as there's no dry there, you're gonna take it. In other words, you're gonna turn off your machine, and we'll just take this paddle off the machine, and then you can see inside the bowl. So at home you do the same sort of thing, pile it onto a sheet tray or a cookie sheet and just cover it in plastic. Okay? And then your hands don't stick to it when you flatten it down. So this is the cookie dough that we had before. Obviously you can see now that it's chilled out. So what we're going to do is to take a smaller piece off of here. So you can see that it's set now. Okay, and it's much, much harder. So even if I were to try and roll this, it would be difficult to do that because it's solid. All right, so to make your life a lot easier, you're gonna break that golden rule of playing with your dough, and you actually wanna play with your dough. So what I'm gonna do here is to break it into a smaller chunk, a little bit of flour, this is just regular AP. And all I'm gonna do is start to manipulate the dough to get it to be softer. Just a little bit of flour. You don't want to put too much of this stuff down. You shouldn't be able to see a big wall of flour underneath. So we're going to roll this. Flour down. Just a little bit. Now you have two choices. I call this the American and the English. All right. This is an American pin. It's a spindle pin. It has a spindle that runs through the center and a much larger chunk of wood in the center that rotates on that spindle. An English pin does not. It's a straight pin and it doesn't have a spindle. So you can see where I'm going to go with this. I'm English, so I'm going to stick with using the English pin. So I'm going to roll and I can control the pressure. Small amount of flour underneath, turn the paste. Keep turning the paste one direction or the other. So you want to go counterclockwise or clockwise. Fairly thick. We're going to place this in, push it down and give it a twist. It's got a nice bit of thickness. It's about 1/4 inch in thickness. Okay. No grease. 325 degrees for approximately 12 minutes. But they are going to get a little bit of a dome to the surface of them when they're baked. And as I say, 12 minutes. By trade, I am a teacher. So I taught at the New England Culinary Institute for 22 years. Before that, I taught adult education classes in England, mostly on my specialized subject, which just happens to be anything to do with sugar. I've been around it all my life, literally all my life. Never trust a thin chef, that's what they say. A pastry chef should always have a little bit of weight to them, because we like eating our own food, that's why. So this is a mixture of egg white and powdered sugar. And when you beat it at a slightly higher higher volume, it turns white. So really, the main ingredient in this, believe it or not, is air. For soft peak. So when you pour the icing up and you have it on a paddle, you can see this little peak mark that it makes. That's how it gets its name. In order to be able to speed up the decorating process, I've made a stencil. So this is just the N from the school's logo. So rolled fondant is literally a type of paste made with just sugar. So what I want to do is to just knead the paste to get it a little bit more pliable, but to also get rid of the thin crust that's on the outside of the paste. And we're going to roll the dough out. So the same sort of thing. We're going to roll and move the paste. So roll it, move it, and you're really moving it sort of 90 degrees each time. Your paste should still stay roughly square as you keep rolling it. And you're moving it because you don't want it to stick to the surface. So we're going to do the same sort of thing. You're going to take your cookie cutter and you want to push it into the surface and give it a twist, but don't jolt it backwards and forward because you're going to distort the shape. So push down, give it a twist, let go. Push down, give it a twist, and then let go. All right. Turn the paste over. So this is flat, this is slightly domed, all right? I don't want that side, I want this side. So I'm gonna put a little bit of royal icing over the surface of the cookie, just a little bit, to make it sticky. You're now gonna take the cookie and place on the fondant, push down, give it a little twist, and then pick it up, and it'll be nice and flat. And then you're just gonna plop it on the surface, make sure you line it up, push it down slightly, give it a twist, and then pick it up, and you've got a nice, even, neat cookie. This is actually an edible food dye. We're gonna place the stencil over the surface. Now, because I chose a medium that is see-through, we can now line up the end to the middle of the cookie, hold it down, and then we're going to spray it. And then when we lift it up, hopefully, we have an end on the inside of the cookie. So this is a way for us to be able to speed up a process where we can make 1,000 of these cookies a little bit easier than painting each one through or stenciling as you would do at home. Because and then lifting it up, and we can have it a little bit paler if we want. And outline the edge. So you can see here, this is just the plain end, which doesn't really have any way of standing out. So then just taking some of the royal icing and coloring it up, I piped around the outside to be able to create that N. So now you can really see it stand out. It gives you the other color of the school, obviously, but also it makes that letter pop now off the surface of the cookie. Hope that you've learned something from this. You're going to be able to take it away. If not, enjoy eating the cookie, because that's the best part. So hope you enjoyed it.